Hello and assalamu alaikum. This is the continuation of lecture number 8, and in this part we will continue with resource extraction. So basically energy is required to extract a certain type of fuel. Extraction of fossil fuels have two main methods that are being used in this world. The two main methods for removing fossil fuel from the earth's crust is the first one is the mining, and the second one is drilling. Mining is basically used to extract the types of fossil fuel that are in solid states. The example of these include coal, and by the digging and scraping or otherwise exposing the buried resources. We dig a mine, for example in Khura mines we extract salt from it. Similarly, there are coal mines and we extract used to extract the coal from there. The other type of method that is used for extracting of fossil fuel is through milling, and by milling we can extract the types of fossil fuels which are not in solid states, but either they are in liquid state or in gaseous form. The examples include the natural gas and crude oil reservoirs. So there are two types of energy in that are involved in the resource extraction. That the first one is the energy extraction energy, that is the energy required to extract a certain type of fuel. And the second type of energy is the fuel energy. The fuel and fuel energy is the energy which is basically stored in fuel, which it releases as a form of chemical or combustion reaction, exothermic reaction. The extraction energy required for 1 barrel of petroleum was 1% of fuel energy in the past times, but now it has increased to 10 to 15% of fuel energy. The major cause of this energy extraction process increase from 1% to 15% is the oil reservoirs are depleting and more energy is spent in their processing and refining and extraction. Fuel ceases to be the primary energy source regardless of the pricing when the extraction energy approaching the fuel energy, means all of the fuel that is being extracted, the same amount of fuel is used in the process of extraction. Now we will come to the second point, that is the transportation sector. The transportation sector of this world is heavily dependent upon the fossil fuel reservoirs and fossil fuel energy resources. As the population is rapidly increasing, and there is limitable or negligible alternatives to the fossil fuels in transportation sector. The fuel cell or battery operated electric vehicles are not yet that developed to take the place of the energy requirement that is being demanded in our transportation sector. Research is going on fuel cells, but the process is slow as compared to the demand growth. So it can be concluded that replacement of fossil fuel with renewable energy resources in transportation sector is much more difficult as compared to the power sector. Now we will discuss the next point, that is the stringent environment policy that are being imposed on the use of fossil fuels for basically production of energy. The more stringent environment policies are associated with competitiveness loss in most polluting sector and a reduction in their export. At the same time, they are linked to the comparative advantage in less polluting industries and boosting their exports. Demand improvement of oil production efficiencies and restricts unsupervised expansions. The demand of oil is continuing to grow with exponentially increasing population level of this world. Oil and gas industries are the major suppliers of energy, but on the other hand, they consume a lot of other resources that include water and other forms of energy. The stringent environmental policies demand the optimization of extraction and refining and water disposal systems to remain in business. More investments are being made on production of environmental control infrastructure to meet these policies, and the result of these policies is that the investor has less profit, so they are discouraged to invest in the oil sector. The example of these policies include Euro 1, Euro 2, Euro 3 and Euro 5 and Euro 6 standards. Oil and gas companies must provide transparency to their environmental control system. So next is the competitive market. The major challenge is to reduce cost, and the major companies have to reduce their cost in order to stay in competition with the rest of the companies. But decreasing this cost for the consumer means that the producer will have less profit. So in order to stay in market, the major the solution that they come out with is they maximize the production efficiency, or also they emphasize on improving the process of extraction and refining. So optimizing oil production systems is a major concern. The oil optimization of oil field production optimization along with reservoir management is central part of company's field development and deliverability strategy. The key factor in production optimization is the capability to mitigate the formation damage during the well construction. There are oil wells and the construction is done. So the key factor in production of optimization of the capability is the capability to mitigate the formation damage of oil wells during construction and production routine operations. Production optimization is the practice of making changes or let's say adjustment to a product to make it more desirable. EOR, that is enhanced oil recovery is basically designed to accelerate the production of oil from well. Water flooding or injection of water to increase the pressure of the reservoir is the basic method that is used for enhancing the oil recovery. That is the basic EOR method. Although the water flooding greatly increases the recovery from the particular reservoirs, but it typically leaves the 1/3 of the oil in that place.